Okay, so I am back. Gamer, you just went over this. You know what's on the back of that? The back, if you hadn't go through the other parts, this should be on the back. Even if it's written over, you want to have your signature with your thumbprint. Okay, if you watch the other video, we'll go over that. That's going to be on the back of this. I did that. Now it's time for the envelope. The only thing I didn't do to the envelope was write my name, capital letters, and my address here. And the front is going to look just like this. There's the stamp. And the back. Confidential written there on both sides. And the stamp. Now what I've done now is all I got to do again is just put my address and name here in capital letters. Enclose this. That's my name there and just have it covered. Money order, I have the back. All this is written on the back. In the appropriate ink. The appropriate dashes or no dashes. And along with that, I have instructions. Notice of tender set off. Attention. If for any reason you do not understand any of these statements or warnings, it is incumbent upon you to summon a superior officer, special prosecutor, or any other competent legal counsel or federal judge to immediately explain to you the significance of this presentment as per your duties and obligations in respect to its public, private, sureties instruments. All right, and again, I just wrote exactly what was on the back just in case they couldn't read it. The exemption ID, that's just an example. Put that's your social security number without dashes, your date of birth without the dashes, deposited to U.S. Treasury, red pen, obligation to pay, blue pen, exemption from levy, red pen, then your name in capital, your social security number again with the dashes, and then again your date of birth with the dashes. And you're going to write money order, foreign test 2016, it's the year 2016, and again your signature with your print. Okay, second page. Again, notice of tender set off. Attention, if any instruments or notices are not corrected within 7 days, citing deficiencies, dishonor, etc., this shall be deemed accepted or approved. Failure to respond within 3 to 7 business days, approximately 240 hours after postmark of this statement, of this presentment of this notice of tender set off, shall be caused the creditor principal undersigned to have executed a certificate of non-response. That certificate of non-response shall be evidence of the correspondence of acceptance. Now, there's other people who were a little more harsher. I don't need to go that route. Then, feel free to call, although any responses or correspondence according to this notice of tender for set off shall be directed to the creditor principal by the USPS certified or registered mail at the following post. Okay, service in any other manner will be deemed effective on its face. And again, with your signature in here. Somebody might ask me why I didn't put that on top of this one, is because usually in statements like this, it's your signature is supposed to go on the bottom. I think it's done this way. Well, this one on the back, on the top of it. I actually have my signature and information, so, like, again, if this was the back, okay, this is how it should be. Your signature goes on top of it, you know, when you turn it, when you get a deposit a check into the bank, you always flip it over, and you put your signature on top. It's always on top, so that's why, this, on the back of, the bill, the back of your bill right here should be this, the back of this. Should be signature on top. Okay, with your thumbprint exemption. Okay, this is what it should be. With that, I gotta actually redo now a couple of these, make it real. Put my real name and real information on here. I gotta put the postmark, and we'll be all set to have this. I'll be looking forward for the next one that comes in, because I did this a couple of times, where if you watch my other videos, I defaulted on my credit card. I didn't claim bankruptcy or nothing like that, but you know, I just didn't pay him back. I just, you know, just completely ignored these people, because, you know, as you know, what they never loaned me anything of value. So why should I have to pay them back my labor? Which, you know, so basically that's a whole nother video there, but I'm going to end it right here, and I'll be uploading this shortly. It takes a while to upload, so be patient. I know the comments, somebody saying, you know, what was taking so long or whatever, but you know, it just takes time to upload and stuff like that. So just make sure you get the right. It took me a few times to actually get this right. I kept screwing up. I put the C the wrong way. Attention CFO, the wrong way. I mean, everything has to be done the right way. Okay, so I have to make sure I even put that the right way. I have to redo this whole thing again. But that's basically all I feel I need to do right here. Other people were a little more harsher about doing stuff like this, you know, with what they're writing down. But this I feel, as the information that I went through, this should all be good. So any questions, hit me up. I'm going to make another video when I'm done with it completely, when I write this out. And I'm ready to send it off. I'll probably make another video and talk about it. All right, till then, hit y'all. Be good.